My name's Yale Stewart, and I draw comic books on the internet for a living. Generally funny comic books featuring little kids. That seems to be my claim to fame. What I'm working on these days is a webcomic called JL8. It is about the Justice League as a bunch of 8-year-old elementary schoolers. At the same time, I'm also working on some creator-owned stuff called Gifted. I first decided to draw as a profession, I guess, when I was probably in like first grade, because I think that was the first time I saw a comic book. And that was when I realized that you could make a professional living doing this. Up until then, I always knew that I wanted to draw, but it was like, oh, I just like to draw as a hobby, because I didn't know that you could make money on it. And then I was like, what is this? And they're like, oh, it's a comic book. People get paid to draw those. And I was like, well, done. That's what I'm gonna do. I did go to art school. I went to the Savannah College of Art and Design in Savannah, SCAD Prime, from 2006 to 2010. However, I didn't major in sequential art, which is our fancy name for comic art. I went there for animation. And that's really the only formal training I've had that I can remember. I may have gone to, you know, a few summer camp things growing up. But other than that, art college is pretty much the only stuff that I consciously am aware that I had. I make my living through JL8, but not through JL8, because I'm not able to necessarily make money directly off the comic, because I'm just kind of like, or at least as far as I'm aware, fair using these DC properties. However, people like JL8, and as such will commission work from me, you know, personal stuff. A lot of times, not even of the JL8 characters. It'll be like, can you draw me as a JL8 type character, like as a kiddie cartoon, or draw Metal Gear Solid, or whatever the case may be, which is all really great. And then, you know, I make a little bit of money doing odds and ends here and there, but no, comics is my full-time gig, and conventions and commissions, I guess, is really how I make it work. In terms of workflow, I certainly fall more in the traditional sense. Virtually everything I do, thumbnails, pencils, lettering, all that stuff, I do traditionally. The only real digital work I do is the coloring, which I scan the pages, upload them into Photoshop. I use CS 5.1, not that it really makes that much of a difference, and I color it in there. Everything else is just pencil, ink, on paper. Webcomics are kind of a blessing and a curse in that everyone's able to technically reach everyone else. The problem is everyone is trying to reach everyone else, and as such, a lot gets just lost in the din. So, just like everything else with the internet, it's a system of checks and balances for the exact reasons I just stated. I know a lot of guys who webcomics have totally worked for them. I mean, obviously, like Kate Beaton, Ryan Pekin, Tyson Hess, Nedroid, MEC, Scott Lava, all those guys are, you know, have done immensely well for themselves through the webcomics medium. But I know some people who are incredibly talented, and it does take a long, long time for them to be discovered if they end up getting discovered. And, you know, that can be really disheartening to a lot of people. So yeah, you got to kind of, you know, you takes your bets and you takes your chances. Gifted is, I mean, it's my creator-owned thing, and basically, it's not terribly original. I'll just openly say that. It's like a pseudo-autobiographical comedy thing. Honestly, if you had to really compare it to anything, it's kind of Seinfeldian. You know, it's essentially about my life fictionalized, but like more so my life with my friends in it and the hijinks that they get into that maybe I'll be like dragged along with. And, you know, it's just meant to be funny and lighthearted, but at the same time, I can't help but inject some drama in there, you know, a la Scrubs or Futurama, because those are huge influences on me as a storyteller. Gifted essentially originated in high school, but I've been working on the thing that I'm going to be like releasing in October. For about, I worked on it for about 4 or 5 months, maybe, if less. I think it's time that I get out of the shadow of JL8 for a little bit. I mean, I love JL8, and if I could get paid to do it for the next long period of time, I would. But I've never wanted to really be another one in a line of artists at a particular studio. Which I guess could sound kind of pompous and egotistical, but you know, you think of all the greats, Art Spiegelman, Craig Thompson, Paul Pope, not that any of those guys, I mean, Spiegelman didn't, but not that any of those guys wouldn't do work for like Marvel or DC, but they cut their teeth or made their name in independent work, and independent work is usually what gets remembered outside of Silver Age Marvel stuff, or, you know, like wildly influential, you know, like the Whedon Cassidy Astonishing X-Men run, but that comes like once a decade. I mean, indie comics get remembered because that's a good question, because like I know why, but I'm not sure how to say it. Because like mainstream stuff, it's not that it's bad, it's just it's a factory, and it has a lot of different workers, and sometimes a lot of those workers want to do a different job from one another. Whereas, like, when Jeff Smith sat down to write Bone, he was going to write that comic that he wanted to make. Like, I don't think that we would remember the Renaissance guys if they all just worked together on paintings in unison. You know, like, we remember Leonardo for his distinct flavor. We remember Michelangelo for his distinct stuff. So yeah, stuff kind of gets homogenized a little bit. And this isn't digging the guys that work in mainstream comics, because I don't care who you are, no one's better than Olivier Coipel. Like, I'm sorry, you know? But yeah, there's something about independent comics. And you can tell different kinds of stories, and stories that generally I find to be more impactful. Like, I'm a huge superhero comics fan. I don't think anything will put me through the ringer like Blankets did. You know, I mean, that's just kind of the way it is. So I guess that's why. I don't even know if that was a clear reason or not, but I did my best.